Welcome to this introduction to the PRA tool. The PRA tool is a decision support tool developed by CABI to assist risk assessors and risk managers to carry out a pest risk analysis for a plant commodity pathway or an individual pest. It provides access to the relevant pest data in the Crop Protection Compendium data sheets and a framework for the PRA process that is closely aligned to the international standards of IPPC, particularly ISPMs 2 and 11. It is provided as an add-on to a CPC subscription and can be accessed via a link from the CPC homepage or by searching for CABI PRA tool in your browser. In this demonstration, I will give you a brief preview of the main features, starting with the homepage, which shows my recently saved PRAs. I can click on the PRA title to view and continue editing, or I can go directly to the report and generate an output from this screen. I'm going to show you around a new pathway initiated PRA as an example. I'm going to click on this button and you'll see that it starts with the initiation page, which is the beginning step for a new PRA. I need to enter a title, and this example is on importing apples from South Africa to Zambia. I need to decide whether it's a demo or a live PRA, and I can select some dates for the start and the completion date. There are some text fields that I can fill out for the background and scope of the PRA. I need to add the details for the pathway. So I'm going to enter South Africa for the country of origin and select Zambia for the importing country. I also need to select the crop, so it's apple. And I have the option here to add the plant parts that make up my commodity. And this can reduce the pest list that's generated. So I'm going to select stalks here that may be attached to the fruits. And I've now completed the basic information that I need to generate a pest list from the extensive CPC datasheet data. Here, I can exclude pest groups that I'm not interested in. This message here tells me that pests with this orange icon have been included or excluded by me in a previous live PRA. For these pests, the tool is using my data instead of the CPC. So we're now on the pest list page. And the first list is of the pests potentially requiring phytosanitary measures. So these are the pests that are associated with the pathway, but that are not recorded as present from Zambia. A second list is also included for the pests excluded from the assessment. And these are pests that are associated with the pathway, but are already recorded as present in Zambia. So if I return to the pests that I'm interested in for this PRA, there are various actions I can take to edit and review this pest list. I can go to the user action menu, and you can see here that I've got an option to view the data sheet, to add a note, to add a regulatory status if it already exists, but also to exclude this pest from the assessment. So if I look at this species, the black cutworm at the top here, you'll see that there's a question mark against the commodity type. This means the CPC doesn't have any information on this aspect. But if I have information from another source that this pest is not carried on apple fruits, I can add a reference and save that information. And you'll see that that first pest has been removed from the list of pests potentially requiring phytosanitary measures onto the list of pests excluded from the assessment. So here it is, the black cutworm has been moved onto this list and is showing with a black icon, which means I've modified it in this PRA. The orange icon is a pest that's been edited in a previous live PRA. So I can do quite a lot of work on the pest list. Once I've checked this basic information, I can then move on to the next step of the PRA process by clicking this button, Select Assessment. Here I have a choice of conducting a rapid assessment to complete the categorization step of the PRA, or to go directly to a full detailed risk assessment. For the detailed risk assessment, the PRA tool presents forms for completing the four steps of probability of entry, establishment, spread, and potential consequences. In each step, there's a set of questions to determine the level of risk, accompanied by a drop-down menu for the risk rating and also for the confidence level for that question. There's a text box to add your evidence that you've collected from the resources you have available. Now, the CPC will be a good starting point for some of the questions. You can access that by clicking on the View Datasheet button. This opens the datasheet in a separate browser window, so you can access the different content sections, and you can keep that datasheet open and return to the PRA to work through the questions. There's a reference section that's accessible from the risk assessment pages. You can click on that and open it and add your references to this at any time. At the bottom of each form, there's a summary section, which has a summary rating and a summary confidence level to select. You can also add an overall note for your rating for that step. So in this case, the probability of entry. Clicking on next will move you on to the next step in the risk assessment. So in this case, it's the probability of establishment. And you'll see that there's another form for this step. The tool doesn't require that you complete the questions in any order. You can work your way through the risk assessment questions when you find information to answer those steps. In the risk assessment summary page, you'll see that the risk ratings and confidence levels are brought forwards to help you to determine the overall risk rating for that pest, and to answer the question, does the pest require phytosanitary measures in this pathway? If you select no, the pest won't be considered further in this PRA. But in this case, we're going to select yes. And I have then the option to save and return to the pest list to assess another pest, or to save and go on to risk management. I'm going to select that. The tool provides a risk management form for each pest, which contains a predefined set of risk management options. I can select the appropriate option and add some details. And then I can save and return to the pest list. As I work through the risk assessment and the risk management for the pests that are of most concern, I start to see the pest risk analysis developing with the individual risk management options for each pest that I've worked on being shown on this summary page. These may be combined to provide import conditions for the commodity, which can be entered in this text box for the PRA report. There are also options to document the next steps and to add the contact details. The PRA can be finalized by clicking on the Change PRA Status to Complete button here. The PRA report can be accessed at any point from the PRA. And you'll see here that it's initially presented as an HTML view. And that can be useful for reading on screen and also for printing. But here you can download a Word version of the report, which is useful for editing offline and obviously for sharing as well. If we just have a look at that, you'll see all the data that's been compiled, and you can use the navigation view here in Word to jump to the various sections quickly. I think that's concluded the workflow for a pathway-initiated PRA. And in fact, the pest-initiated PRA route is very similar. There are also forms for the risk assessment, for the risk management, and for the PRA summary page. The main difference is that there may be multiple pathways of entry to assess. The tool will create separate probability of entry forms for each potential pathway you select, and you can add risk management measures to each pathway. The PRA tool provides flexible options for team working on a PRA, both online and offline. When working with colleagues who have access to the tool, it is advised that you set up a team and create your PRAs in what we call the team view. All members of a team can view, edit, and download the report of PRAs that are saved under that team name. So, for instance, these are the PRAs that have been created by the CABI PRA group. Team members can also invite other members to join their team by email. For offline working, the risk assessment and risk management forms for individual pests can be exported to Word from both the pathway and the pest PRA types. They can be edited outside the tool and imported back into the tool. This may be useful if you wish to involve experts outside your immediate PRA unit, or even if you want to work on the PRAs when your internet connection is not reliable. You can also download reports of the pest data sheets from the CPC. So I think I've shown you the main features of the PRA tool. Further details are provided on the tool help page. Please take a look at the user guides and also the training materials, which are shown here. And check back regularly to see if there are any updates to the PRA tool at the bottom. If you have any queries or would like to find out more, please contact us at pra@cabi.org. We would be very pleased to hear from you.